الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، it's important for us to always remember our Islamic adab and Islamic akhlaq. As unfortunately we see, especially in the world and the realm of social media, we see many sisters that don't wear proper hijab or don't wear hijab at all, many sisters who wear makeup, and many sisters who have language unbefitting of a Muslim, cursing, using some of the most vile and filthy language. And likewise, we find that with the men as well. It's not just a phenomenon of the women. And with that being the case, we have to go back and measure what we have to say on the scale of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if we look at the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we see the hadith where the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, ma min shayin atqalu fi mizan al mu'min yawm al qiyamah min husn al khulq wa inna allaha yubghidu wal fahish al bidi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there isn't a thing which weighs heavier on the scale of a believer than good manners, and verily Allah hates wicked conduct and sinful speech. This hadith that you'll find in Sunan Tirmidhi is a hadith which lets us know that we are always going to be held accountable for what we say and what we do, and that the Muslims should distinguish themselves from the other communities by having righteous manners and righteous conduct, and that it is not sufficient that we just have a shakl of Islam, meaning that we have names that are Muslim names and that we have the attire. For example, the women, there are women wearing hijab, women wearing niqab, doing some of the most foulest sins outwardly and speaking in very vile ways and using horrible language. Likewise, you have brothers with big beards and short thobes doing this and that and looking the part, but their speech and their act and their conduct is unbefitting of a mu'min and unbefitting of even a Muslim, perhaps, at times. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rectify our condition and our affairs and help us to rectify ourselves and be better believers. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.